to Elite Bytecode. Today, we're going to talk about functions in JavaScript. Now, the key things to remember when creating a function in JavaScript is that you need to create a function and then call it. Now, functions in JavaScript really function as things that you assign tasks to and then they can execute them, all right? And that is the basics of programming. All you gotta do is to assign a task to a computer and the computer needs to execute that task. So how that works is by using functions. So in this example, we're gonna look at something like greeting, saying a greeting to anybody, all right? So we're gonna create a function and the name is gonna be greet. Now, function is the keyword. That's a built-in keyword in JavaScript. Now, the name of the function is greet. And right now, what we're gonna do is just to create a simple console.log. So console.log just prints out whatever message is assigned to it within the console in your browser. The main point of function is to receive arguments and then execute tasks based on those arguments. Now, arguments can be any variable of any type. They could be strings, they could be numbers, name it. In this scenario, we are just making it very simple to just assign the name Jan. And then Jan is being sent to the function. So I'm going to show you how you can declare arguments within the function. So normally on line number 6, when you assign that string, so in JavaScript within line number 2, that function should expect that string. If you declare a number, it should expect a number within that function. So the way we're going to do it is that we're going to assign the name Jan when we're calling the function, and then on line number 2 within the function, it's going to be sent to that very argument. In this very case, the argument is name. Now when we are console.log, we're going to say hello plus, which is concatenating, name. So name is the argument that's going to be executed, and you can see in the console.log that hello John is being printed. Now we can add additional arguments by just using a comma within the arguments on line number 2. And now if we call hello Mary, we need to assign a second name, all right, into a second argument into line number 2, and then that's how both names should be included within the console.log. Now, in JavaScript, one thing you need to remember is that JavaScript is really crucial. When it does not see anything assigned to it, it's normally gonna declare that undefined. So you need to pay attention to that. Now, in this very scenario, to resolve this issue, we just need to assign, on line number 6, we just need to assign an additional name because the function is really expecting two names, okay? It's really expecting two names, so you need to assign two variables on line number 6. And that's pretty much it. When we're calling functions, remember, just if you assign two arguments within the call function, you need to assign when you're assigning two variables within the call function, you need to assign two arguments within the function. Thank you for watching and goodbye. I don't wanna jinx it, baby.